Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install hyperterminal in your industrial operating system. So let's begin. Now you previously may have already used terminal like command prompt, right? You might have also used mingw terminal, right? So that is basically, you know, that git bash terminal what we call. This time I am going to show you a completely new terminal called hyperterminal. It is quite similar to, you know, git bash, but still I was going to show you how to download and install this hyper terminal, right? So there is one trick that is basically you need to modify your Windows configuration file to basically use your hyper terminal. So I am going to also show you that. So for that, please stay tuned to this entire video and I'm going to, you know, show you all of that. So for that, you need to first download your hyper terminal. So just, you know, simply go to your favorite browser and enter at this bar, just simply type hyper.js download. Yeah. And then you'll be getting this first result is from hyper.is. So just, you know, simply click on this hyper.js. And I'll be also putting this link in the description so you don't need to worry about that link and all. Right, so you'll be getting this link right at the description. And now if you just simply scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this download hyper button and version is 3.1.2. So to download, you need to just simply click on download hyper. And this is, you know, going to open a new tab and you can clearly see our hyper has been, you know, rightly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this hyper setup 3.1.2 has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And then let us first minimize our download directory. And you can clearly see our, you know, hyper setup installation wizard has been, you know, rightly opened. And this is going to be, you know, our installation destinations. If you want to change your installation destination, you need to just simply click on browse and you can change that. But I'm going to, you know, keep everything as default and then just simply click on install. And now, as you can clearly see, it has, you know, rightly started installing. So it is just a 60 MB file, so it won't be taking that much of time. So you can clearly see it has almost completed installing our hyper and it has rightly completed. So you need to just simply check this run hyper and then you need to just simply click on finish. Yep. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly installed. So it's going to launch our hyper terminal within a second and it has, you know, rightly launched. Right. And now I'm going to show you how you can edit your config file. That's a very important step. So for that, you need to just simply click on this, you know, hamburger icon, and then you need to just simply click on this edit, and then you need to just simply click on preferences. And you can clearly see this .hyper config file has been, you know, rightly opened. In here, you need to just simply paste a simple code snippet that I'm going to, you know, provide in your, in our, you know, description link. So you will get that link. So this is basically the code that we are going to, you know, copy and paste. So you need to just simply copy that. I'll be putting this entire code in the description. Maybe you'll be getting a link, so a GitHub link. So if you just follow that GitHub link, it'll be redirect you to this page. You need to just simply copy that, you know, configuration, and you need to just simply paste that over this dot hyper. So just, you know, simply control all, then delete, and then simply control V to basically, you know, paste everything, and then just control save. Yep. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly saved over here. And now you need to just simply cancel it. And if you just again simply cancel your command prompt, that is this hyper, you know, terminal, and if you just simply open it once again, you can clearly see our hyper terminal has been, you know, rightly opened. So in this way, you install the latest version of hyper in your Windows 10 operating system. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also please do share with your friends. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.